Hi students, this is maths video for grade 3. Today we are going to see the next lesson. Now open your book to the page number 76. What is the lesson name? Fun with give and take. Fun with give and take. In that previous lesson, or the third lesson, already we lesson name is give and take. In that lesson, we learned about addition problems, word problems. In that lesson, we are going to learn subtraction, and then subtraction wording problems. First one, in a cricket match. Cricket match. In a cricket match, Sri Lanka made 235 runs. India has made 123 runs. How many more runs does India need to win? How many more runs does India need to win? What is the keyword here? More. More is the addition keyword. But here what they ask, how many more runs does India need to win? Already Sri Lanka made 235 runs, but India is 123 runs. They ask how many runs need to win. How many runs need to win? Now I explain in Tamil. Evlo run edutha India win aagum. Like that they ask. Now to win, India must to make 236 runs. In a cricket match, if opposite team get 100 runs or 120 runs, means next opponent team want to get 121 runs, then only that team is they will tell that team is winner team. Now runs India needs to win. Runs India needs to win. Here the difference they ask. So Sri Lanka runners 236, India runners 123. Now look at here. Let's subtract by taking away ones from ones. Taking away ones from ones. See, runs to win 236, but runs by India get 123 runs. Runs by India get 123 runs. They separated hundreds, tens, ones. Hundreds, tens, ones. 236 minus 123. 6 minus 3, that is 3. Next, 3 minus 2, that is 1. Next, 2 minus 1, that is 1. So how many runs need? 113 runs. Here the ant is asked, to win India needs more than 100 runs or less than 100 runs? Yes, 113 is more than 100. So A, more than 100 runs. So we are left with 100, 110s, 3 ones. To win, India must make 113 runs. For runs, for cricket match only, we added the one number, 236. If it is normal sum, means you just consider that this number, what they given in the question. Next, try it yourself. Geeta had 368 rupees in her purse. She bought a book for ₹123. How much money is left in her purse? Left is the subtraction keyword. Money left in her purse is ₹368 minus ₹123. Now we are going to solve the problem. Money in Geeta purse, 368. Cost of a book, 123. 368 minus 123. So 8 minus 3, that is 1s. 8. Here 8 1s. You have to subtract the 3 1s. Now remaining how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here you write 5. Next, 6 tens, you have to subtract the 2 tens. So cancel the two tens. How many tens remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, 3 hundredths. We have to subtract 1 hundredths. Remaining 2 hundredths. So, totally, how much money is left in her purse? Rupees 245. Again, the aunt is guessing. Money left in Geeta purse is more than 200 or less than 200? Yes, that is more than 200. Now, turn the next page. Can you help Nabila? Can you help Nabila? Nabila's mother sent her to the market to buy some things. She gave her rupees 245. Nabila bought 1 kg ghee for rupees 127. The shopkeeper gave her back rupees 98. Kilogram is written as kg. Already you know that. Did the shopkeeper give her the right amount? We have to check whether the shopkeeper gave her a right amount or not. How we will check? How much she gave to her? She gave rupees 245. But Nabila bought 1 kg ghee for how much? Rupees 127. So, how much she gave and then how much she spent in the shop? This two numbers you have to subtract. Money Nabila had 245. Cost of a ghee 127. So 5 minus 7, that is possible? No, it is not possible. Why? Because here only we want a big number. Here we want small number. But it is an opposite. So we have to borrow. So we cannot take a 7 ones from 5 ones. So borrow from 10. 10 is made up of how many ones? 10 ones. Now we have 15 ones. So if we borrow, here it will become 3, here it will become 15. So 15 minus 7. Here from 15 ones, take away 7 ones. Only 8 ones is left. If we take 7 ones from 15 ones, we have remaining 8 ones. So here you write 8 ones. Okay. Next. Now take away tens. Only 1 ten is left. See 3 minus 2. Already we have only 3 tens. If we cancel the 2 tens, how many tens we have? 1 tens. Next, how many hundredths we have? 2 hundredths. The answer is, we want to cancel the 100. So, how many ones left? How many hundredths left? Only 100 left. So, what is the answer? 118. So how many tokens left? 100, 1 tens, 8 ones. So what is the answer? 118. The shopkeeper had given Nabila rupees 118? No. How much he gave? He gave only 98 rupees. How much more money should the shopkeeper give Nabila? How much more money should the shopkeeper give to Nabila? We have to subtract. What is the original amount? 118 he wants to give. But how much he gave? 98 rupees. So 8 minus 8, 0. Next. Here 1 minus 9 is not possible. So we want to borrow. Here it will become 0. Here it will become 11. Sorry. So 11 minus 9, 2. So he want to give back rupees 20 to Nabila. Look at the next page, practice time. Baby tortoise is 33 years old. Mummy tortoise is 150 years old. How much younger is baby tortoise than mummy tortoise? in that more than less than means you have to subtract that. They ask how much younger is baby tortoise than mummy tortoise. The age of mummy tortoise is 150 years. Age of baby tortoise is 333 years. They ask the difference. Age means they ask the difference. So we want to subtract 150 minus 33. 0 minus 3 is not possible, so we want to borrow. Here it will become 10, here it will become 4. So 10 minus 3 is 7, 4 minus 3 1, and there is no 1 at 100, so the 1 will come downwards. So baby tortoise is 170 years younger than mummy tortoise. Next, Aravind has read 69 pages of a storybook. Gauri has read 95 pages of that storybook. Who has read more pages and how many more? Now I explain in Tamil. Who has read more pages? Evlo pages onna vida munnadi padichirukan. How we will calculate? We have to subtract. Then only we can calculate. For example, you had a 3 chocolates, but your friend had a 5 chocolates. Now I ask the question, who has more chocolates? Your friend has more chocolates. How many chocolates more than you? More than you means you have to subtract. Like that only, 95 minus 69. We have to write the bigger number, 95 minus 69. 5 minus 9 is not possible, so we want to borrow. Here it will become 8, here it is 15. 15 minus 9, that is 6. Here 8 minus 6, that is 2. How many more pages he has read? 26 pages. 26 more pages he has read. Next, Reena noted the electricity meter reading. Electricity meter reading of her house. Last month reading was 118 units. This month reading was 193 units. How much electricity did she use in 1 month? How we calculate? We have to subtract that. What is the last month reading? What is the this month reading? First, we want to write the this month reading, bigger number. Next, the smaller number, last month reading. So, this month reading, how many units? 193 units. Last month reading, 118 units. Now, look at here. 193 minus 118. Here 3 minus 8 is not possible, so we want to borrow. Here it will become 13, here it will become 8. So 13 minus 8, how many it will come? 8 after you 13, keep it in your mind. Have to count 8 after 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. How many we want? 5. We have 5 fingers. Like that. 8 minus 1. 8 minus 1. 7. See, 8 in a mind. 1 after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many fingers we have? 7 fingers. Next, 1 minus 1. The same number means 0. So, totally she used how many units? 75. Units. Next, Gushpu bought a shirt for rupees 125 and trousers for rupees 165. How much money did she spend altogether? Here, altogether means what? Addition keyword. So we want to add that. How much money did she spend altogether for both things? Bought a shirt for rupees how much? 125. For trouser, 165. So here we want which symbol? Addition symbol or plus symbol or minus symbol? plus sambar. Next, 165 plus 125. 5 plus 5, that is 10. Carry 1. 6 plus 2, 7, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. Next, 1 plus 1, that is 2. So, she spent rupees 290 altogether. She spent rupees 290 altogether. Thank you, students. Remaining part we will see in our next class.